快的到沈阳来，我们都非常想念你。
好，我们也希望你们来圣地，我们想见你在圣地。
好的，我们会去看你咕噜，谢谢 Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。Hare Krishna. Kanchinima.
Kanchinima.
Okay, we're Om Jnanatimarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksuran Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Vancha Kaupata Rubyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaihevacha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. All right, do you remember anything from yesterday? We will ask Guru Mani, we will ask the devotees there. With Sati, any of them can remember anything from yesterday?
Krishna.
Okay, can you go to what you got?
Do
it. Okay, and how? Hayo Chitada Renka Yeshua Iga. Okay. Diga, Diga Shishama.
To eradicate the pollution in our heart.
Yes. What's the example Krishna, Lord Chaitanya uses? What example does he use in the Shikshastikam in the first verse?
那九禅那尼亚在八信规的第一条当中，他打的比喻是什么？今年的积尘，失去今年的积尘，失去今年的积尘。To eradicate the dust. accumulated for years.
And where is the dust?
这个尘尘土是在哪里？
And what is Lord Chaitanya compares the heart to what?
就是他要把心比喻成什么？
镜子。
Okay, yes, the mirror. And then he gives another example. He talks about.
就是很远。
The other example was the lotus flower.
主舍参加举另外一个例子，举了一个莲花的例子。
The opening, the blossoming of the lotus flower. So Krishna consciousness is like the beginning of auspiciousness.
这个例子就像莲花的盛开，Krishna 之觉。是非常吉祥的，是吉祥的开端。
Then we heard about the life of the wife of transcendental knowledge.
接着的比喻是超然知识的妻子的生命。
And how we get a taste of the real happiness for which we are always anxious.
以及我们如何获得恒常渴望的甘露
，and then the bathing of the soul，
以及对灵魂的沐浴
，removing all of the contamination, gross and subtle，
去除粗糙与精微的一切污染。
So now we are chanting, and we may wonder.Well, you know, I'm chanting, and I'm not experiencing these things.
那现在我们可能就对自己打了个问号了。我都念诵了，怎么我还没体验呢？
Well, I don't know. Maybe you are. Are you experiencing? How many of these seven things are you experiencing?
那你也不知道，也许你体验到了。那你们对这七大好处，你们到底就是体验到了哪些呢？
You're very quiet.
你们那么安静。
快乐。
Happiness.
Are you?You're experiencing that happiness? That's good. We should be happy, yes.
是的，我们应该我们该快乐。
When Prabhupada would give initiation to devotees, he would often say, chant 16 rounds and be happy.
当圣帕巴德给门徒启迪的时候，他总是会说唱诵，请唱诵十六圈，变得快乐。
Krishna Kumari, are you happy?
I'm happy. I'm happy.
You're happy, yeah?
Krishna Kumari, Tabuzai.
Tabuzai, Jintan Milai.okay, okay. I can hear that all of you, you're all very happy. So I assume she's also happy.
Nagu 说他可能听出来你们都很快乐，所以 Krishna Kumar 一定也是快乐的。
But we want that happiness should increase. It should increase more and more.
我们希望这种快乐会增加。
咕噜我来了。
哦，来了。
快乐，快乐，快乐。
非常的快乐。痛苦来、痛苦来的时候，只会让我离 Krishna 越来越近，这是我的感受。每一次痛苦来，都把我推向 Krishna 一步。
你快乐的时候 ，Krishna 越来越远。
是感受到这种痛苦的仁慈，然后这种善良属性的快乐，先苦后甜。
Okay, very good. So we want you to experience transcendental happiness.
我们希望您能体验到超然的快乐。
Everyone should be happy. So some people, they're in the family life, and some people are in the detached life. It doesn't matter what condition you're in, we should all chant Hare Krishna and be happy.
有些人处在家居生活，而有些人处在气绝的生活阶段。无论处在哪个情况下，都希望唱诵 Hare Krishna 变得快乐。
So we may wonder,why, you know, many people are chanting Hare Krishna, but they don't all experience these seven different results of chanting Hare Krishna.
We might wonder, there are many people chanting Hare Krishna, but they might not experience chanting Hare Krishna that brings these seven blessings.
So Lord Chaitanya explains the reason for that in the second verse of the Shikshastikam.
如柴丹尼亚在八信规的第二个诗节解释了原因。
Right, nam nam makari bahudani jasarva shaktis tatrapitani yamitas marane nakala etadrishitava kripa bhagavan mamapi durdaiva midrishami hajanina nuragaha. Right, translation.
大家一起来读背诵这个世界的译文吧。
祝德巴圣圭第二。
主啊，是您的父母生我无耻，
因此你有现在如非智那或恶人那那样的
名字，
您将一切超然的能量。赋予这些超然的名字，唱诵这些名字，并无硬性规则。主啊，由于仁慈，您让我们唱诵您的声音，听以前听。可是我太不幸，没有被这些圣灵所吸引。一个人，
yes, very good.The Lord Krishna is so kind to us, he has given us so many nice names to chant. And in all of Krishna's names, there is great transcendental energy. And there's no special rules for chanting. Anybody can chant anytime.And any place.
唱诵圣名并没有特殊的规定，任何人都可以唱诵，可以在任何时间、任何场、任何地点唱诵。
Of course, some places are more auspicious for chanting than others.
而有的地方，比别的地方更加吉祥，念诵起来。
When we want to chant japa, we should be careful. You know, maybe you're driving the car and you shouldn't try to chant japa with your beads when you're driving the car. It's not recommended for safety.
念诵 japa 的时候要小心的是，当你开车的时候，你可不能手里还拿着念珠袋儿。 这个对于安全来说是不推荐这么做的。
You can chant. Use your tongue to chant. But keep your hands on the steering wheel and concentrate on the road.
你可以用舌头唱诵，但是你的手还要放在握紧方向盘，眼睛还得盯着前方的道路。
And a very powerful time to chant in the day is in the early morning.
而念诵很有力量的时间段是清晨的时间。
If we leave all of our chanting until the last thing in the evening, that is not a very good plan.
如果我们把念诵留在我们晚上最后一件事来做的话，这可不是一个好的计划。
We want to do our chanting. Try to do as much chanting as you can in the early morning.
我们希望尽可能的把我们的圈数在大部分都在清晨完成。
Right. There's a time in the morning called Brahma Muhurta, which means it's about an hour before the sun rises.
有一个吉祥的时刻叫 Brahma Muhurta, 就是在日出前的一个小时。
So in the Holy Dham, in our temples also, we do the Mangal Arti at the time of the Brahma Muhurta.
在圣地，我们的庙，我们会在 Brahma Muhurta 的时间段做 Mangal Arti 灯仪。
In India, at this time of the year, the sun rises about 6 o'clock, so the arti is at 4:30.
一年在印度的时候呢，在这个时间，太阳是在6点钟升起，所以 Mangal Arti 是在4:30.
Of course, if you're ever in your part of the world, the sun rises later. And so you can have Mangal Arti later.
然后在我们在你们所处的地方呢，太阳升起来时间要晚于这个时间，所以你们可以在稍晚的时间做 Mangal Arti.
But it's good to wake up early, even though the sun hasn't risen. You try to get up ahead of the sun and begin to chant.
但是早起是非常好的习惯，您可以尽量的就是在太阳日出之前就起来念诵了。
The chanting is more powerful because our mind is more controlled at that time of the day.
在这个时间段所的念诵是非常有力量的，因为我们在这个时间段的心意就容易控制住。
So Lord Chaitanya is telling us that there are many names to chant and there are no rules about chanting, no special rules. You can chant any time and any place. But he said we're very unfortunate. Why? Why are we unfortunate?
卢卢查丹尼亚就说了，念诵圣名没有什么规定，任何时间都可以，任何地点都可以。但是我们是这么不幸，那到底为什么我们这么不幸呢？原因何在呢？
We'll ask Cherumai. Weishima woman, Putsinyun. Krishna Kumari, Nijada, Weshama woman, Businyun. What is this?
There are too many dust covering our soul.
Too many what?
Dust.
Oh, too much dust traveling our soul. Yes, Well, what Lord Chaitanya says in the Shikshastikam, Lord Chaitanya is answering the question. Lord Chaitanya says, we're very unfortunate because although we have so many nice names to chant, we don't have attraction for them. So we're going to talk about what is this problem? Why is it we're not attracted to the chanting of the holy name? These are major anarthas which are in our heart, which are stopping us from being attracted to the holy name of Krishna. One problem is that we don't have a proper understanding about the philosophy. We have not fully understood our position as a spirit soul. We are thinking ourselves to be very important or very, very essential in the world. Srila Prabhupada told the story about how we're so insignificant, we're simply one tiny soul in such a huge universe where there's so many people, so many living entities, even so many planets, and still we're thinking we're the center of the universe.
Srila Prabhupada就说了一个故事
Another problem which we have is we have the tendency to identify some people as our friends and other people as our enemies.
另一个问题就出在于我们倾向于把某些人认同为是朋友，而把某些人认作是仇敌。Prahlad
Maharaj was speaking about this to his father, Hiranyakashipu.
Prahlad Maharaj 就这一点对他的父亲 Hiranyakashipu 如下说道。
Prahlad was telling his father, we should see everybody equally. We should think of everyone the same, that we're all friends. We shouldn't make distinction, friends and enemies.
Right.
Hiranyakashipu had put Prahlad Maharaj in the Gurukula for the demons, and in the demon Gurukula, they were training him how to deal with his enemies. Told them, you have an enemy, and first of all, you can try to give him good instruction. And if he takes instruction, then he'll accept your authority. If he doesn't take your instruction, then you try to bribe him. You give him something to encourage him to accept you as his authority.
倘若你的敌人，接受你的教导，他接受了你的权威的话，那就没有问题。倘若他不听你的，你可以贿赂他，贿赂他，鼓励他接受你为权威。
And then if he doesn't, if the bribe is not enough, then you may have to use physical violence to deal with him, to suppress him. Just like politicians, they'll put their enemies in jail, or they'll have them even killed.
倘若贿赂不生，没有效果的话，那么就要采取，这种暴力手段来镇压他。就像有的时候，他们会把他的敌人投在监狱里，或者甚至是谋杀他。
So this is described in the Bhagavad Gita. In the chapter 16, we have divine nature and demoniac nature. So the demons, they will make distinction who is a friend and who is enemy. And the enemies, they want to kill them.
在《薄伽梵歌》的第十六章，描述的神圣品质和邪恶品质，所以恶魔们他们就会做区分哪个是敌，哪个是友，他们就会采取相应的手段。
If someone praises us, we'll say, "Oh, he's my friend." And if somebody criticizes us, we'll think, "He's my enemy."
有人赞美我们，我们就会把他认作是我们的朋友；有人要批评我们，我们就会把他视为敌人。
Actually, the person who criticizes you is your real friend, and the person who praises you is actually your enemy.
实际上，批评你的那个人才是你的真朋友，而赞美你的那个人才是你的敌人。
But because of ignorance, we are thinking the other way.
因为愚昧，我们就把那个想考虑的方式正好相反。
So false ego is the problem. We're in the material world and we're thinking, I am the controller, I am the master.
问题出在假我上，因为我们在物质世界，所以我们就会认为我是控制者，我是主人。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, he's the proprietor, he's the enjoyer, he's the best friend. But we're thinking, I should be the best friend.
在《薄伽梵歌》当中，主 Krishna 说，他是拥有者，他是享受者，他是最好的朋友。但是我们却认为，我才是最好的朋友。
So this is our false ego. We're in ignorance. We don't want to accept Krishna's authority.
这是由于假我，由于我们的愚昧，我们不想接受 Krishna 为权威。
And this is because we don't accept Krishna's authority, that's why we suffer in the material world.
正是由于我们不接纳 Krishna 为权威，所以才在物质世界受苦。
So we have to understand what surrender means.
那么臣服到底是什么意思呢？
Do you remember the verse in the Bhagavad Gita where Krishna says, give up all religion and surrender to me?
你们能不能回忆起在《薄伽梵歌》哪个世界主 Krishna 说放弃一切最近宗教向我臣服呢？
Have you all read that? Okay, you've all read that verse? Yes? Good. So tell me, what are the six things which are required for surrender to Krishna?
那接下来就请你们讲一下臣服 Krishna 就需要哪六个条件。
We'll ask Sati, give me one.
Seven.
Start everybody off. Give us one thing, one item. Of the six, with our surrender.
那大家都可以轮流说其中，举出一个臣服的先决条件。
Krishna, come. Yes. Okay. 你说。 You sure? Anybody? Chitada Renka, you sure?
Radha Priya
knows. Don't touch it down. Radha Priya, Goswa.
Accept everything favorable for Krishna consciousness.
Yes, right. Yes, good. That's the first thing. And then what's the second thing, Radha Priya?
She said reject everything that's unfavorable for Krishna
consciousness. Yes, right. So we have to know what is favorable for Krishna consciousness and what is not. This is the problem. Sometimes devotees get confused. What is actually good for my Krishna consciousness? You know, if you stay in a family with people who are not devotees, you get some people telling you that, oh, a little bit meat is very good for you. No, drink a little wine is very nice, you'll feel good.
喝一点酒是挺好的，你会感觉飘飘然。So
we have to know what is actually good for devotional service and what is not.
我们就一定要知道了，对奉献服务而言，哪些是好的，哪些是不好的。Some
people may say, oh, to sit and chant Hare Krishna all day, this is not good.
有些人就认为
But for a devotee, you think, yeah, very nice, very good. And what is unfavorable for Krishna consciousness? Of course, that is activities which are against the regulative principles.
那哪些活动是不利于Krishna直觉的呢？就是违反规范原则的事物。
Intoxication, meat eating, gambling, illicit sex, these things are all very harmful for our Krishna consciousness. But for the materialist, that's their life.
除麻醉品、肉食、赌博、非法的性。
So we have to know what is actually good for our devotion and what is not. So this is the first point we want to mention to you about what harms our taste or our attraction for the holy name. Okay, then the second problem which obstructs us in developing a taste for the holy name is the problem that we have a taste for temporary material things.
那其次呢，就是阻碍了我们对圣名的品味的 事物是我们对短暂的物质事物反而也津津有味。
We may have a desire for luxury, for material comforts in the form of luxury living, luxury surroundings.
我们对于奢华的物质生活，比较就是豪华的环境啊，这种生活起居呀，可能津津有味。
It's like having a desire to go to the heavenly planets.To enjoy the comfort or the luxury of the heavenly planets.
好像有点想去天堂，去享受天堂的舒适，天堂的奢华。
We're thinking to enjoy more luxury, more comfort, there will be less suffering.
我们以为只要有更能享受到更多的舒适，更多的奢华便利条件，我们痛苦就会减少了。
Sometimes we're chanting Hare Krishna, and our purpose in chanting Hare Krishna is not simply to go back to Godhead, but it's to avoid suffering.
有时候我们念诵 Hare Krishna， 我们抱着的目的不是仅仅回归守神，我们的目的是怎么避免痛苦。
And sometimes we want to have like mystic powers. We can control the material nature.
有时候我们渴望有玄秘的力量，可以控制物质自然。
And we simply want to get free from the material world. We want to get free from all the suffering which goes on in this material world.
我们就是想着要怎么摆脱物质世界的种种痛苦。
So this is not really in line with our the mood of devotion. If we're thinking just, oh, I don't want to suffer, so therefore I'm going to chant Hare Krishna. This is not the mood of pure devotion.
那么这跟我们的奉爱服务的心态就不一致了。就是我们唱诵 Hare Krishna 是想着怎么不再受苦，这个不是纯粹的奉爱。
So we want to think about giving service, taking the trouble to give service to Krishna, not to worry about our own self, but to think about Krishna.
我们希望不辞劳苦的，想着怎么去服务 Krishna, 而不是，为了自己，因为我们的对象是 Krishna。
So having this desire for our own material self, this is an obstacle to our devotion to Krishna.
有对于我们自己的愿望，这就是我们对 Krishna 的爱福就造成了一种障碍。
Then another problem which obstructs us from Krishna is that we have the tendency sometimes to find faults with other devotees.
另外一个，就是阻碍了我们去接近 Krishna 的问题，是我们有挑奉献者毛病的倾向。
We think, oh, I've been a devotee longer than that person. I should be senior to that person.
我们就想我当奉献者年头可比那个人长，我是年长的奉献者。
So we're thinking, I'm senior, they're junior. This is not the mood of devotion.
我们就认为我的资格老，他的资历浅，这种想法可不是奉爱。
The mood of devotion is to be the servant.To think of ourselves as the servant of the servant, many times the servant of Krishna.
我们的心态应该是仆人的心态，仆人的仆人 Krishna 的许多遍的仆人的心态。
And sometimes we become simply attached to objects that have nothing to do with Krishna consciousness.
有的时候我们干脆就依附那些跟 Krishna 之间丝毫没关系的事物。
So we have to be conscious. We have to be first conscious and then become Krishna conscious.
所以我们首先要有知觉。其次是有 Krishna 知觉。
Sometimes we're very eager to get position and to become famous as a great devotee.
有时候我们对地位非常渴求有一个地位，想在 Krishna 知觉中成为一名伟大的奉献者。
There was one devotee. He became a devotee. Then he got initiation.And then he became the temple president. And after he became the temple president, then he became the manager for the whole state.
曾经有一个奉献者，他得到启迪之后呢，他就当了庙长。他当了庙长之后呢，他继而又管理了整个的州，就美国的一个州。
And after the problem was after that, he decided he must be an incarnation of Krishna.
在这之后，他就自以为他一定自己就是 Krishna 的一个化身了。
And told the devotees they should all worship him.
他就吩咐奉献者来崇拜他。
So sometimes we get people, they become the guru.They become the spiritual master, and then after they become the spiritual master, then they think they become the avatar, the incarnation of the age.
有的时候有人当上了 guru, 成为了灵性导师，然后呢，他就觉得他自己就是个年代化身了。
So we have to be very careful about these kind of moods coming in.That we want to become recognized as an important devotee.
所以我们对这种心态就要小心。有的时候呢，我们希望被别人认出我们是非常重要的奉献者。
We should always remember Lord Chaitanya's teachings to be humble, to think of ourselves low and fallen.
我们要谨记住柴丹内的教导，自己要非常的谦卑，而认为自己很堕落。
So there's one more thing which is also a problem in obstructing us from developing our attraction to Krishna, and that is the tendency to commit offenses.
继而又有另外一个问题阻碍了我们受到 Krishna 的吸引，就是有冒犯的倾向。
There are different kinds of offenses. There are offenses in deity worship. There are offenses in dealing with devotees, and there are offenses in chanting the holy name.
有不同种类的冒犯，有对神像的冒犯，对奉献者们的冒犯，还有唱诵圣名的冒犯。
If you read the book, The Nectar of Devotion, then in that book, they have listed 64 different offenses to be avoided in worshipping the deity.
如果你们阅读了《奉爱的甘露》这部书当中，就讲到在崇拜神像的时候要避免的64项冒犯。
So worshipping the deity is very serious responsibility. We bring a deity to our home. It can be a blessing, but it can also be a problem if we don't worship properly.
所以崇拜神像是非常严肃认真的一件事，是要负责任的。 我们把神像请到家中，它可以是对我们的家的一个祝福，但如果我们不正确崇拜的话，它也是一个问题。
In the past, sometimes there would be a deity in the village, and the people would be worshipping the deity in the village, but gradually they would reduce the worship. And instead of worshipping every day, they would worship once a month.
在过去的年代，村子里都会崇拜神，然后逐渐的呢，他们就减低了崇拜的标准，他们不是每天崇拜。而变成了一个月才崇拜一次。
Then they decided, why worship every month? Once a year will be enough, and they would worship once a year.
后来他们又下决定，干嘛要一个月崇拜一次呢？我们应该一年崇拜一次就好了。
And then, of course, because they're only worshiping once a year, after some time they forgot all about the worship.
那么这样，他们每年崇拜一次之后呢，他们逐渐的就把这个崇拜这事儿彻底的忘光了。
And when they forgot all the worship, after some time, then there would be a disaster in the village, and there would be a famine, and many people would die.
那么过了一段时间呢，村子里就发生了灾难，这个。就有旱灾，然后饥荒，村子里的人都死了。
You can see in Nepal, Kathmandu, there were many beautiful temples there in Kathmandu, but they were not worshipping regularly. The temples would open maybe once a year, one time in the year, they would go and do something.
在尼泊尔的加德满都首都，那里有很多美丽的庙宇，但是他们并没有有规律的进行崇拜。他们一年当中呢，只开放一段日子，在这段特定的日子崇拜。
So just a few years ago, there was a very serious earthquake, and the temples almost all were destroyed. They fell down.They were seriously damaged due to the earthquake.
在几年之前呢，在那里就发生了一场大地震，所有的庙宇都被地震在这个灾害当中都倒塌了，庙宇都毁坏了。
This was an indication that the Lord was not pleased.
这就表明主。
So if we don't worship the deity properly, certainly we will get reactions.
所以如果我们不恰当的崇拜神像的话，肯定会招致反应的。
Now sometimes people think because they're worshiping the deity, they don't need to chant. They think, well, I don't have time now. I'm just doing deity worship. I don't chant.Now that's another offense.
而有的时候，有的人他认为我现在崇拜神像了，我根本没时间念诵了，所以他们不念诵，那这变成了另一个冒犯了。
In the course of worshipping the deity, there may be offenses, but by chanting the holy name, we can remove the effects of these offenses by our service to the holy name.
在崇拜的过程当中，有可能做出冒犯，但是通过唱诵圣名就能去除这些冒犯的效果。通过我们服务圣名，就能去除崇拜神像冒犯的结果。
So service to the holy name is very powerful. It can help us to eradicate all of our offenses.
服务圣名是非常有力量的，可以去除我们所有的冒犯。
Just like Number one offense in chanting the holy name is to commit offenses against devotees, for Vaishnava aparad.
唱诵圣名的第一条冒犯就是对奉献者的冒犯，这是 Vaishnava aparad.
But by chanting the holy name, we can be forgiven for all the offenses to devotees.
是通过唱诵圣名，我们对奉献者的冒犯就得以宽恕。
Of course, we should never deliberately take advantage that I will offend a devotee and then chant the holy name. That would be sinful.
当然了，我们不应该有意而为之，我们想着，就利用这个，念诵圣名去冒犯奉献者，然后认为就得到宽恕了，这可是有罪的。
We often recite in the morning a special prayer which says that one may chant the holy name for many births, but if we do not take care to avoid the 10 offenses, then we will not get the love of God, which is the ultimate goal of this chanting.
我们有时候在早上的时候背诵一个诗节，这诗节的大意就是说，我们也许生生世世的，就是唱诵圣名，但是如果我们不小心避免冒犯的话，那么我们就得不到终极的神爱的结果。
So we should be very careful not to commit offenses at the lotus feet of the holy name. Because the holy name is not different from Krishna. And if we offend the holy name, it's like offending Krishna himself personally.
所以我们要小心，不要做出冒犯，不要在圣名的莲花足下做出冒犯。圣名和 Krishna 是一样的，我们冒犯了圣名，就是冒犯 Krishna。
The most common of the 10 offenses is to chant without proper attention.
唱诵圣名最普遍的一个冒犯就是唱诵不专心。
And from that one offense, by chanting inattentively, all the other offenses will come.
只是通过不专注的念诵圣名，就会导致做出所有其他的几项冒犯。
How can we learn to chant with proper attention? That's something we're going to speak about this afternoon. We'll be talking about how we can chant with more attention.
那么如何才能带着恰当的专注来念诵圣名呢？就是今天下午我们要主要讲的话题，如何专注的来念诵。
But,I think you're all familiar with the 10 offenses. Did you say the 10 offenses this morning? Okay. So what's the first offense?
第一条是什么？
Yes, right. This is called the mad elephant offense. We have to deal very carefully with the devotees. Just like some very important person wants to give his wealth to us. Right? Maybe there's some very rich person and they want to give a donation to us. And if we criticize that man's servants, will he be pleased or will he be offended?
就好像一个富人，一个重要的人物，给我们一些钱财，他要给我们做一些布施。如果我们批评了这个富人的主人的话，那么这个富人他会不会对我们满意？会不会还是觉得受到冒得罪了呢？
Jeremiah, 干嘛呢吗？如果我们冒犯他的仆人，你觉得那个有钱的人满意？Hare Krishna.
Charumai Maharaji, ke da ne mai.
Radha Priya.
Bu mai yi.
Bu mai ni do. Xie xie. Wei shen ma? Ni shuo. Wei shen ma bu mai ni?
Yi yi wei dui yu fu ren lai shuo, ta de pu ren jiu shi ta de dai biao.
Hen hao.
Ru guo ni bu neng rang ta man yi de hua, jiu deng yu bu rang fu ren man yi, jiu shi ni hai shi mei you.
Do it. Very good. Right. Yes, because he's the representative of the master. So we should respect him. He's acting on behalf of his master. So the devotee is representing Krishna. And if we disrespect the devotee, Krishna will not be pleased.
这个仆人他就是他主人的代表，他是代表主人在做事情，所以应当得到尊重。奉献者们他们是 Krishna 的代表，如果对他们不敬的话， Krishna 肯定不高兴。
And if there's this very rich man, if he has many assistants, and if these assistants are if we disrespect them, then also he will not be pleased if we criticize them. And if we criticize the books which describe about this man's power and position, then it will not be very good for us either.
那么也还有一些还有书籍，这个书籍描述了这个人的力量，他的地位。如果我们批评这个书籍的话，无疑对我们也不好。
And if we say, oh, everything they say about that man is not true, it's just imagination, it's not really true, he's not really like that, then that means we're giving some interpretation to it. So that's another offense.
接着呢，倘若我们就说，哎，这个人他不是真实的，他只是想象出来的，不是那么回事的话，那么这就是一种对这个人的解释，这也是一个冒犯。
Or if we do something sinful, very sinful, and then we say, well, I'm a friend of this wealthy man, so he'll protect me. Then that's not good.
我们可能会做罪恶的活动，然后还自称我是这个人的朋友，他一定会保护我的，那这也不好。
Sometimes people say, well, I'm a devotee, so I did something wrong, but I'm a devotee, you should forgive me.
有的时候我们就是说，我们是奉献者了，虽然做了错事，也应当得到宽恕。
But that's not proper way to use our relationship with Krishna.
这个不是对我们和 Krishna 之间的关系的一个正当的一个善用。
So certainly the holy name will not be pleased if we don't act properly.
如果我们行为举止不端，肯定圣名不会满意。
So chanting the holy name is the means to actually approach Krishna, to actually come to actually see Krishna and to be with Krishna. We can achieve that through the chanting of the holy name.
唱诵圣名是接近 Krishna 的手段。 使得我们可以看见 Krishna 跟 Krishna 在一起。
But if we say, oh, the holy name I've been chanting, it didn't work for me, we criticize this holy name, it's not so holy, something wrong, it's not working for me, then that's an offense.
但是如果我们批评圣名说，哎呀，这对我根本不起作用，这圣名哪有什么神圣的，对我根本没效果，这也是个冒犯。
Think somebody says this, oh, the chanting of the holy, just an imagination, that's offense.
有的人说这个唱诵圣名就是一个冒，就是一个想象而已，那这是一个冒犯。
So when we commit offenses, then certainly we will get results. There will be bad reactions coming from it.
倘若冒犯了圣名，无疑会招致，罪恶的反应。
And these effects may be not only in this one life, they may come in the next life.
那么这个导致的结果呢，可能不会在这一生显现，也可能会下一世才显现。
So these results will be things like, We want to do devotional service just to get something for our own pleasure, not for Krishna.
那么这其中的一个结果呢，就是我们从事奉献服务，我们想为自己捞取好处，而不是为了 Krishna 而做服务。
Yeah, we have these desires, the things we want to enjoy still in the material world.
我们还想在物质世界享受一番。
And we want to get them by doing service for Krishna.
我们是想透过为 Krishna 做服务来获得我们想要的事物。
So that's actually a result of offensive chanting of the holy name.
这个是由于对唱诵圣名的冒犯导致的其中一个结果。
Another problem comes, we can lose our faith. We lose our faith in the process because of our offenses in our devotional service.
另一个问题呢，就是由于在奉爱服务当中从事做了受了冒犯，我们对这个方法失去了信心。
So then we start to minimize all of our different devotional activities. We become less and less conscious, less and less careful about rules and regulations.
我们降低了、减少了奉爱服务的活动，我们的知觉水平越来越低，我们在遵守规范原则方面越来越不谨慎。
We start to move away from Krishna.
就我们开始离 Krishna 越来越远。
And we become attached to things which are really against devotional service.
我们开始依附起那些有违背奉爱服务的事物。
Just like nowadays people all have mobile phones and they use their phones, they won't use it for Krishna, but they use it to watch movies or they watch some other.Sports program or some mundane things.
就像当今年代呢，手机特别普遍，人们有的人他用手机并不是为了 Krishna， 他是拿手机看电影或者看那个体育竞赛或者世俗的事情。
Especially now with this pandemic, which has been going on for some time now, so for some time.Temples have been closed and there's been no activities going on in the temples and so people become, many of devotees become affected, they become weaker and weaker in their Krishna consciousness.
特别是在现今疫情这种条件下呢，庙宇都纷纷的关闭了，也没有什么活动，甚至奉献者也受到影响。他们的 Krishna 知觉越来越弱。
instead of chanting the holy name more, they go to watch movies more and read mundane novels.
他们不是更多的唱诵圣名，他们反而的看更多的电影，看更多的小说。
And this is like a drifting, just like you have a boat, which is there at the side of the, maybe at the land, just at this, it may be in the harbor, but if it's not properly tied up, then as the tide goes out, the boat may begin to drift, and you don't realize the boat's drifting. And when you look around, you find the boat is way out in the middle of the sea.
就好像有一艘船，这个船的那个船停泊在岸边，但是如果没有把这个船系在好好的系在锚上，那么随着涨潮潮起潮落，逐渐的这艘船呢，它就渐渐的离这个海岸越来越远。
So we have to be very careful not to get slack in performing devotional service. We have to keep up the standards.
So we have to be very careful not to get slack in performing devotional service.
But at the same time, we shouldn't become proud that, oh, I'm an advanced devotee. We should always remain humble.
与此同时，我们不应该骄傲，自认为我是一个进步的奉献者。相反，应该谦卑。
So offenses are very dangerous to our progress in Krishna consciousness.
冒犯对我们 Krishna 知觉的进程是非常有害。
So in Krishna's holy name.He has given us all of his wonderful potencies.
So, in the name, Krishna, in his name, has given us all of his wonderful potencies.
But we are so unfortunate, we don't have attraction for the chanting.
But we are so unfortunate, we don't have attraction for the chanting.
So we want to be aware of these different anarthas which are there in the heart.
So we want to be aware of these different anarthas.
Lord Chaitanya performed a wonderful pastime to show us how careful we have to be in cleaning the heart.
Lord Chaitanya 给我们展示了一个奇妙的消时光。告诉我们在清洁内心的时候要多么的小心谨慎。
That was the cleaning of the Gundicha temple just the day before Rath Yatra. Lord Chaitanya went to the Gundicha temple with all the devotees and they cleaned the whole temple.
在 Radha 团车节的头一天，如柴丹亚带领所有的奉献者去了Gundicha庙来清扫Gundicha庙。
They cleaned the ceiling, they cleaned the walls, they cleaned the floor, they collected all the dust and sand and everything which should not be there. They collected it and they threw it far away from the temple so it would not come back in.
他们收集了所有尘土、沙粒，还有不应该有的，他们把他们都扔得远远的，好让他们不要再回到庙里。
And Lord Chaitanya had them clean it again. After they cleaned it one time, he said, "Now clean it all again."
主柴丹亚清扫完贡丁城庙一次之后，他又清扫了一次。
And Lord Chaitanya took off his own cloth.And began to clean the temple with it. In this way, he was showing all of the devotees how careful we have to be to clean the heart.
He, in this way, he was showing all of the devotees how careful we have to be to clean the heart. 展示了我们在清扫内心的时候要多么的仔细。
Remember yesterday I gave the example? Sometimes we don't realize how much dirt is there.
那你们还记得昨天上课的时候，咕噜举了一个例子，就是我们是用了一个物体来比喻，我们在清扫的时候，我们是多么有的时候根本就没有意识到它有多么脏呢？
What was the example?
有谁能说出是哪个例子呢？
Anybody remember?
有谁记得这个例子吗？
I gave the example, nobody remembers, about the carpet.
那课当中呢，不是举了一个地毯的例子。
Who remembers?
谁能记得讲了些什么？
对。
Yes.
当我们把地毯抖动地毯的时候，会有很多很多的灰，一层一层的灰被灰尘，就是就像那个要需要用那个。推铲机去铲它，那么多的灰。
So there are so many dust on the carpet that we should use the machine to move it away.
No, that's not exactly how I described it. I said this dust on the carpet, it goes below the carpet. It falls through the carpet.And when you pick up the carpet, you see all the dust below the carpet.
Guru 讲课的时候说的是，这个灰啊，它就从这个地毯的上面，它就渗到了地毯的中间，甚至它都渗到了地毯的底层。当我们拿起这个地毯的时候，发现这个灰尘，就地毯下面也积累了一层一层的灰。
You just clean the top of the carpet, you don't know all the dirt is going below the carpet.
如果你们只是把这个地毯表面的浮土来把它清扫了之后，你们就忽视了从这个地毯表面上渗到地毯中间，甚至到了地毯下面的这些层层的灰。
So like that, we're cleaning our heart. We think, oh, my heart's clean.We don't realize how much dirt there's still there in the heart.
在我们清理我们内心的时候，我们也许自以为，哦，我已经把我的心打扫干净了，但是还没有意识到，在我们心底还落着多少的积尘。
Material desires.
这些灰尘包括物质的欲望。
Sometimes we desire position, we desire respect.
有时候我们渴求得到一席之地，渴求得到别人的尊重。
So we have to be very conscious, very careful to control the mind.
我们要有知觉的、有意识的控制心意。
All right, so we'll stop now and we'll ask if there's any questions today.
今天的正课部分就讲到这里，接下来是回答问题的时间了。
I've been asking questions to you. Now it's your turn to ask questions to me.
那在课上的时候呢，我一直在给你们发问，现在该到了轮到你们提问了。
哎，姑姑，
对，我有一个问题，就是唱诵声名十戒和专注念诵是相辅相成的，是吧？也就是说，要想做到专注念诵，也必须要做到唱诵声名十戒。你做到这些的话，也就可以做到专注念诵了，是吗？
A question that, to be attentive to the holy name and the ten offenses to the holy name, the two are parallel with each other. If we become attentive, then we will not make offenses, that ten offenses. And if we do not make those ten offenses, then we'll become very attentive. Is that so?
Well, I hope so.
希望是这样。
It may be that we're attentive, but that our mood is that we want to give trouble to someone, or we want to commit offense.
那么也许呢，我们专注念，我们专注，但是我们心态是想给别人捣乱，找麻烦，我们想去冒犯别人。
Someone's coming chanting the holy name, but they don't have faith in the process of the holy name, and they just want to give trouble to others.
Oh, 有一种人，他们也来装模作样的念诵，但是他们丝毫没有信心，他们只是给别人捣乱。
But that's an unusual situation. Generally, what you say is true. If one is attentive to the chanting of the holy name, then he will not commit offenses.
当然了，刚才所说的是，你就不是很普遍的一种情况。一般来说，如果专注能做到专注的念诵的话，就不会做出其他的冒犯了。
We have to know what are these ten offenses. If we are going to avoid them, we should know what these offenses are and be careful not to commit offenses.
如果我们想要避免这些冒犯的话，我们就要知道唱诵圣名十戒，然后去小心的避免。
Someone may think they can take advantage of the holy name by performing sinful activities and then using the holy name to counteract the sinful reactions.
有一些人呢，他们利用了唱诵圣名，然后他们去从事一些罪恶的活动，之后呢，他们又希望能够通过唱诵圣名来抵消这罪恶活动的反应。
And some people think, oh, we shouldn't tell people to chant the holy name of Krishna because we are thinking that's the ninth offense, to instruct the holy name to faithless persons.
还有人认为我们就不应该告诉别人去念诵圣名，因为唱诵圣名十戒的第九条就是对毫无信心的人宣扬圣名的荣耀。
But we can tell everyone to chant Hare Krishna.But we don't tell them the glories, we don't tell them the specific power of the holy name.
但是我们应该去告诉每个人去唱诵 Hare Krishna, 但是我们不要告诉他们圣名的荣耀，圣名的力量。
Certainly our Sankirtan parties go everywhere, and Lord Chaitanya predicted the holy name would be chanted in every town and village. But it doesn't mean everyone will become a devotee.
我们的 Sankirtan 队伍，他们到世界的各个角落唱诵圣名。主彩丹尼亚就预言了，他的圣名会传遍每一个城镇乡村。但是并不是每一个人都会成为奉献者。
But we try, we want to put the seed there in their heart and try to let it grow.
但是我们在努力的。把这个种子播撒到他们的心中，让它成长。
Of course, sometimes we sow the seed, and the seed is sown in barren land. The seed will not sprout, will not grow.
我们也看到，有的时候这种子就撒在那个荒芜 荒郊野外，而这种子也不成长。
But still, Lord Krishna is pleased that we have given the holy name, we have distributed His holy name to everyone.
但是如果我们将圣名派发给每一个人的话，古 Krishna 就会对我们满意。
So even though they may chant the holy name with some disgust, but their chanting of the holy name is some benefit to them.
即便有人是带着厌恶的情绪来唱诵圣名的话，也对他们有好处。
Ajamila's chanting was not perfect, but he got great benefit from chanting the holy name.
Ajamila 的唱诵并不完美，可是他从唱诵圣名当中就得到了巨大的好处。I have two questions. By which method should we remove the accumulated dust in our heart?
We remove the accumulated dust in our heart by chanting the holy name.
就通过唱诵圣名去除内心的积尘。The next one is, how can we know that the dust in our heart is less and less?
Well, that's why we explained yesterday the seven benefits of chanting the holy name.
昨天呢，我们就讲了唱诵圣名的七大好处，七大祝福。
So you should feel how your consciousness is becoming cleansed and purified.
就被清洁了，干净了。
There should be an awakening of transcendental knowledge.
超然知识在内心得以唤醒。
Just like when you eat, you know when you've eaten a meal, you will feel satisfied, you'll feel relief from hunger, you feel satisfaction and nourishment.
就像你吃东西，你吃每一口，你都觉得你的饥饿感消失了，你就感觉到满足，你就感觉身体得到了滋养。
In the same way, when you chant the holy name with some sincerity, you will feel the effect of the chanting in the form of relief from attachment to material things.
如果您唱诵圣名是怀着真诚的态度，那您就觉得您就摆脱了对物质事物的依恋。
You will feel the awakening of transcendental consciousness.
您会感到超然的知觉慢慢的复苏了。
You will be thinking of yourself not as the body, but as soul.Part and parcel of Krishna.
您会认为自己并不是这个躯体，而是灵魂，是 Krishna 的所属部分。
So this awakening of consciousness should come by the chanting of the holy name.
通过唱诵圣名，这种知觉便慢慢的复苏了。
One of the benefits of chanting of the holy name was described Vidya Vadu Jivanam. It is the life of all transcendental knowledge.
圣名的其中一大好处就是 Vidyavadu Jivana， 它是超然知识的妻子的生命。
So with the chanting of the holy name, you attract Bhakti Devi into your heart, and along with Bhakti Devi comes all of her associates, like transcendental knowledge and detachment from material things.
通过唱诵圣名，就可以把 Bhakti Devi 奉爱女神吸引到我们内心。嗯， Bhakti Devi 来了之后，她的同游也一起来了，那就是气绝，还有超知识。
Yes.
没有声音那边。
Hare Krishna， 能听到我说话吗？
听到了。
能。
不对，我一直在听，刚才打不开麦。我有一个问题，刚才说到了唱诵圣名会有很多反应，会甚至会影响到下意识。Hare Krishna， Hare Krishna，
Hare Krishna，
阿铁要说话。
Haribo，
啊，就是唱诵圣名，就是冒犯的唱诵圣名会有一些不好的反应，会甚至影响到下一世，但我就有点担心，有点害怕那个。那这一次，如果就是就我现在来说，就是我现在的这个状况的时候，我唱诵声明就很不专注，也会有冒犯的唱诵。那我怎么做能更好的去那个去唱诵声明啊？我有点担心，有点害怕。
Just now I mentioned that offensive chanting or even have effects on our next life. So I'm a little bit worried and I'm afraid of that, because now my chanting is not so attentive and even there are offenses. So what should I do that I can chant better?
What you can do is to chant more. More chanting will help you to improve the quality of your chanting.
多念诵可以帮助你提升改善念诵的质量。
We have to practice. So you're still practicing. We're still practicing. And how do we practice? We chant again and again and again.And the more we chant, the more, the better the quality will become.
现在呢，我们都在练习阶段，所以我们需要反反复复的念诵，多念诵，好的品质就会到来。
We shouldn't be surprised that yes.My chanting is not very attentive, my mind is wandering. We have to train the mind, we have to practice. It's going to take some time. But Krishna wants to see our sincerity, and Krishna will help us. The more we desire, the more Krishna will help us.
那我们不应该惊讶。就是我们念诵不专心，我们的心意到处的游荡，我们又就要训练我们的心意，我们要休息练习，那么这样需要花时间。Krishna 会看到我们，当他看到我们的真诚的时候，他 他就会帮助我们。当我们想要得到 Krishna 帮助， Krishna 就会帮助我们。
That's very nice. You have a sincere desire to improve the quality of your chanting.
您想要改善念诵的质量，这是非常好的。
So take the opportunity to do more chant. It, sometimes you chant on beats and sometimes you chant without beats. But chant. Don't think I only chant on beats. You can chant without beats also. You can also chant without beats. You can be chanting constantly.
那么就是应该好好的把握住机会多念诵。有的时候呢，您在念钟上念诵，有的时候呢也没有念珠的时候也念诵，就要恒常的念诵，不断的念诵。
Of course, we chant. We have to do sixteen rounds on our beats. But after you do your 16 rounds on beats, then you can chant without beats, and you can just chant. You can be chanting all the time, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, chant.
在您念完16圈之后呢？这是念珠上面的，那么就在放下了念珠之后呢，也要一直念诵，在任何时间，无论您在哪里，无论在做什么事情，要始终的如一的在念诵着。
And I also know that it's a fact that if you chant in front of your altar where your deities are, your chanting can be good, better. If you're chantingYou know, if you're just chanting, sitting in front of a television or sitting around the house somewhere, you want to be there where your altar is, where your deities are, and chant there. Chant to the deities. That's very nice.
那么有一个事实就是说，在神坛面前念诵，或效果会更好。如果换了一种方式，你坐在电视机前面，或者随随便便的坐在房子的哪个地方念诵，这个比起那个你坐在神坛面前对着神像念诵，那个效果就不一样。
And if you can chant with other devotees, just like the devotees.Sati's organized this program, devotees coming together. When you're together, the chanting is more powerful.
就像 Sati 组织的这个奉献者在一起，这种情况，跟奉献者一起念诵会更有力量。
Sit with the devotees.And together, they all chant.
和奉献者坐在一起，大家一起念诵。
No talking.
念诵的时候不闲谈。
Turn off your mobile phones. Don't answer your mobile phones. Turn them off. Put them away, and say, "This is my time for chanting."
把你的手机关掉，把手机放在别的地方，然后告诉自己，现在是我念诵的时间。
Okay.
So my question that we are individual soul. Originally we are, we have knowledge, and now it is covered. When the dust is removed by chanting, and we are purified, then the original situation will appear. Is it true?
Yes, that's right. What's the last sentence? Is this what?
Is that when by chanting of the dust, the covering of the dust is removed? Since we are our individual soul, we are original, we have knowledge. Under the circumstances that the Vedic knowledge will revealed automatically?
Yes, all the knowledge is there within the holy name. When we chant the holy names, all the knowledge, all the Vedas is there within the Maha Mantra. Of course, you have to chant very powerfully, very purely to get the full benefit of the holy name.
您的唱诵必须是有力量的唱诵，要纯粹的唱诵，这样呢才得到圣灵的全部的祝福。But
we have some acharyas in the line of the cyclic succession that they were not educated materially, but they were very knowledgeable of all spiritual topics.
我们的传系当中有一些 acharya， 他们是在物质上是没有受过教育的，可是他们充满了灵性的知识。The question is that after the individual is purified, since the individual soul is original such an end, then knowledge will reveal by itself, of the original knowledge.
Yes, the original knowledge is all there in the heart.
是的，就是原本的知识都已经就在内心当中了。
Remember, the nature of the soul is Satchit Ananda. It means eternal, full of bliss and knowledge. This is the nature of the soul.
灵魂它是Satchit Ananda，灵魂的本性就是永恒，有知识，极乐。So
when we awaken the full nature of the soul, all of that knowledge and the eternal nature will all be revealed to us.
所以当灵魂的本质被唤醒之后呢，那么那些知识、永恒和知识的本性都自动的揭示了。And
of course, we should feel supremely blissful in transcendental consciousness.
而且我们也会在超然的知觉当中感受到极乐。
Right. We say, chant and be happy. Nobody's happy in material world, but devotees are happy.
我们总是说唱诵并快乐，在物质世界没有一个人快乐，可是奉献者却整天非常快乐。Right,
you're all happy, you're all very blissful.
你们都是很快乐、很极乐的样子。
Because you're chanting Hare Krishna, you're talking about Krishna, you're in Krishna consciousness.
因为你们都唱诵 Hare Krishna, 谈论 Krishna, 处在 Krishna 之间。
But as soon as you go outside, as soon as you go back into the material world, then you'll see how miserable people are and how much they're suffering.
但是一旦你们出去回到物质世界，你们就会感受到物质世界的痛苦，那里的人们是多么的受苦。
So we said chanting the holy name, one of the benefits is it extinguishes the blazing fire of material life.
所以在讲课当中说，唱诵圣名的一大好处就是它熄灭物质存在的熊熊火焰。
Is Charumati there?
Charumati.
No. Hi. Okay. Right. So Charumati, did you ever experience the blazing fire of material life?
Charumati, 你有没有感受到物质生活的这种熊熊火焰的灼烧呢？
Yeah, I think all of us have experienced the fire of material life.
我认为我们每一个人都明显的感觉到物质存在的这个火焰。
And that's why we've come to Krishna consciousness.
所以我们才来到 Krishna 之间。
Because by chanting the holy name, it put out that fire of material life.
通过唱诵圣名，这物质生活的熊熊大火就逐渐的熄火了。
Nobody's happy in the fire of material life. Everybody's suffering.
在物质生活的大火当中，每个人都痛苦不堪。
Oh, fighting and quarreling and arguing and then killing.
人们彼此的争吵不休，在那里喋喋的在那里辩论，而且甚至导致了这个互相的杀戮。
That is the material world. Every day, going on every day like this. We want to get away from that life. We want the real life. And the real life is there.In Krishna consciousness.
这种事情是在物质世界天天上演的，我们就恨不得马上的逃离那，我们想要去 Krishna 世界当中的真实的生活。
You have to chant the holy name. You have to take up Krishna consciousness. You have to follow these regulative principles.
那么您就得唱诵圣名了，你要。并且遵守 Krishna 之间的这些原则。
These are the principles of freedom. We want freedom. We're thinking freedom means to eat all garbage, to kill the animals and eat them. That's not freedom.
这些才是自由的原则，使我们导致自由的原则。但是我在物质世界，人们以为。去吃那些垃圾食品，然后杀掉动物吃他们的肉，这才是自由自在的。
There people are thinking freedom is illicit sex, gambling, intoxication. That's not freedom. That's their slavery to their modes of nature. They're controlled by their mind and senses.
物质世界的人们以为能够自由的去从事性。赌博和麻醉品，这个才是自由自在的。但是，这实际上他们已经成为了物质自然属性的奴隶，他们成为自己的心意感官的仆人。
But the devotee experienced real freedom. We get relief from the material nature. We're able to transcend the modes of nature by chanting the holy name.
奉献者们才是真正的自由自在的，他们已经超越了物质自然形态，他们唱诵着圣名超越了。
As soon as we begin to chant, we immediately experience relief from the material energy.
一旦我们开始唱诵，立刻就能感觉到物质的能量离我们远去了。
Remember Draupadi, they were ripping off her sari and she just called out to Krishna, Oh Krishna, Oh Govinda. Immediately Krishna came.
还记得当 Draupadi 处在那个 即将被剥下衣服的危急时刻，他呼唤着 ：“Oh Krishna, Oh Govinda！” Krishna 立刻就出现了。
So everyone, put your hands up in the air.
现在请大家把手都举向空中。
And call out loudly the holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Rama, Rama, Hare Hare.
Did you see Krishna?Did you feel his presence?
你们感受到 Krishna 的临在了吗？
感到吗？
感到了。
Jai, very good, yes.
对对。
还有孤独的仁慈。
Okay, any other question? Yes, yes. Sati, you 说什么？
是我们今天的课是不是就可以到这里了
？Okay, 可以，马上。Okay, 我们下午会来啊，几点？你的时间七点？
对，我们下午四点钟是趁着这个发布给我们讲这个柴丹娘和圣明的这个主题。然后晚上是七点半
，Gurudev
您再回来。
我是七点半呢、啊、，OK。
对。
OK， 好，
辛苦了 ，Gurudev， 感恩您。
晚上见。Hari Bol, Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda ki. Jai.